αξίε το τραγουδοποιό. Ο τραγουδοποιός έστω
βλέπεις. Η τραγουδία κινείται μεταξύ τριών.
Behold, I've kept myself alive.
It was the one job I gave you, Socrates. I knew you could handle it.
I would have attempted it even if you hadn't told me to.
It's not as easy as it seems, staying alive. There's not many of us left.
Then let's pay tribute to them. Though they aren't here now, they were here once. Come with me. My opinion on death is a nebulous one, because I know nothing about it. Therefore, I know I shouldn't be afraid.
I'm not afraid either.
Many are, because they don't know what death holds for them. One can only trust that the gods know for certain.
Think wisely, although no one can truly know anything.
Phoebe. She never got to be a little girl. I talked to her like she was already grown up.
Which you did out of respect for her. Question your choices, Cassandra, but never doubt them.
Thank you for giving her the burial she deserved.
There are countless others here in Elysium. The blessed have earned that eternal happiness. One of them is our great Pericles.
Athens owes him a debt for all he's done.
They didn't call him the first citizen of Athens for nothing. A man of many contributions, but also a private man.
Only he had shared his burden.
We only knew him as he presented himself to be, but who's to say that wasn't his true self?
This war has taken so many. Even Brasidas fell.
Maybe so, but as a Spartan, he fulfilled his duty and died on the battlefield.
I could have helped him more. He was on my side.
Your survival avenges him. He will be honored as a hero.
The people will remember how we brought down Cleon.
I heard Cleon was found on the beach. Massacred, no less.
It was no worse than what he would have done to his own people. I had to follow through.
Either way, let him spend his eternity in Tartarus for what he has done. And be certain, our friends wait for us in the light.
I drink to that.
Who am I to say no?
Well, this has supplied me with plenty of new material for my next play.
Cassandra killed the Monger as an act of espionage. That's exciting. Write a scene like that.
There's been no love scene yet. Let me provide that inspiration now.
Beauty is short-lived. You may as well use it, Alcibiades.
And to that, I raise my drink.
To us, who have persisted through everything, and to those who wanted to persist.
A tribute as good as your singing.
And to the gods.
Now, dear teacher, I think you should whisk me away for our private lesson.
I'm afraid I haven't had enough wine for that, Alcibiades.
Then someone fill his cup!
Thank you. Are you lost, Mistima?
I see something. Sounds human. Better check it out.
Clean kill.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I should...
I've lost them! This will be easy!
What are we going to do?
Don't worry. It's curable. What's wrong?
My workers are sick. At this rate, I won't be able to feed my own family, never mind theirs.
The good news is, this isn't the work of the gods, but a sickness of the body. The throat in particular. I could treat the workers, if I had my medical supplies. Mystios, would you get them for me? I wouldn't want them to suffer. Well said. Such goodwill deserves a reward, doesn't it?
Huh? Of course, yes. I have something worthwhile to trade for the service. Will you do it?
I'll find your supplies. Excellent. My tools are in Ancient Pearl, and the drugs are in Lover's Bay.
Ancient Pearl is pretty big. Where exactly did you leave your tools?
In the clinic at Vrisa Fort.
Where exactly in Lover's Bay should I look?
At the Leader House in Midilini, northeast of the temple.
I'll come back with your supplies.
The faster you do, the sooner I can help the workers.
I'll go get the tools and drugs. I'll go get the tools and drugs. Hella! Look at these vineyards. Even Marcos couldn't make shitty wine with these grapes. That must be Vrissa Fort. Let's go. I hope no one notices me here. Physician's tools. I have what the physician asked for. I should take it back to the vineyard. My brother sleepless night over. I found your supplies.
Thank you. These are specialized items. I couldn't have replaced them in time.
Oh, my grapes are saved!
I get the feeling that's all you've cared about from the start.
Without grapes, there is no work. By healing the workers, you've saved my farm. Take this.
Okay.
should stay hidden if I don't.
The beasts, the teeth, too many teeth. You saved me in my work too, a cure for the statues in the Petrified Valley.
Why would stone need to be cured?
Surely, you've seen their faces frozen in terror. They're not mere objects, but humans trapped in stone.
You're saying they're sick?
I'm not sure why it's happening. I'm merely a scholar looking for a cure. An elixir that will not only heal, but prevent this horrible affliction once and for all.
Something's turning people into stone, and you can make them flesh and blood again? Impressive.
Yes. Well, not exactly. Not yet. It will be perfected through more trials. But I only have one dose of elixir left. In order to make more, I would require a few ingredients. But I'm in no condition to gather them.
What do you need?
Just a few items found all over Vineyard Canyon. If you can get them for me, I'll reward you with a dose of my elixir.
I'll gather what you need.
Excellent. Now listen closely to these ingredients. I require a cluster of bear dung mushrooms, some cone snail bile, and a bouquet of hellebore.
How did these statues come to be?
I don't rightly know. A curse of the gods, the writhing dread. If you wish to see for yourself, you shouldn't do it without my elixir.
What is a hellebore?
Hellebore is a flowering plant you can find growing atop the highest mountain in Vineyard Canyon.
Where can I find these mushrooms?
They grow on fresh bear dung. There's a cave in the mountain south of the road to Mytilene where you can usually find them.
Where can I find cone snails?
Cone snails are drawn to the warm currents of the eastern shoreline. My favorite spot is by Sark Bay. Make sure the bile is fresh.
I'll go collect your ingredients.
Come to my workshop on the hill east of Mytilene when you have everything.
A cave, a mountain, and the shoreline. Items be in three more different places? Off we go now. Mm.
mountain. The hellebore should be here somewhere. Shipwreck. The cone snails must be close by. They won't ask any questions.
You are mine!
Yeah!
This is the right area. The cave with the mushrooms should be close. Move! The crazy woman has been writing about the petrified forest.
You're back. Do you have the ingredients?
I do.
Very good. Now I'll be able to make a new store of elixir. But first, I need to make sure it's safe for human consumption. The vial on the table is my last dose. I saved it especially for you.
I'm not drinking anything with bear dung mushroom in it.
Don't be silly. Drink it, and you'll be impervious to petrifaction.
I'm not sure about this.
What? You believe my elixir works, don't you?
If it does what you say it does, I'd be a fool not to drink it.
Yes, drink it all down. I noticed something while testing the elixir on my life subjects. We all turn to stone when we're dead. They're not statues! They're my children!
Ah!
easy.
Do you have fear in your heart?
I should cut out yours just for asking.
Ha! I have a highly lucrative job offer, a dangerous one too. If you had fear in your heart, you might not be fit for the task at hand.
Fear is natural. It helps us survive.
Ah, but survival is never guaranteed when facing bears.
What do you want with them?
I need some skins to make some breastplates. The best come from Chios Island, north of Chios City. I'll make one for you too, if you get them for me.
I'll get the bearskins for you.
Excellent! If you survive, I'll reward you with the finest breastplate ever created.
I have the feeling you could talk about bears all day. I'll return when I have the skins.
Do hurry. I've got paying customers waiting for breastplates made from those skins.
I need to sail to Chios Island to get the bearskins. Calm down and tell me what's wrong.
My husband, he's late. No, missing. He and his friend have tracked a giant wolf south of Mytilene. They want its pelt.
He better be a good hunter.
Without knowing, all I can do is worry.
If you say so.
Can I hire you to find my husband and kill the giant wolf for me?
Why would I need to kill the wolf? I can just bring back your husband and his friend.
If you don't, those two idiots will continue their hunt. I need this nightmare to stop, and I'll give you my husband's helmet as payment.
I'll find your husband and kill the giant wolf once and for all.
Thank you, Mystios. If there's anything I can do to help...
What makes you think it's not just an ordinary wolf?
My husband says it's twice the size as any he's seen.
Where south of Mytilene did he track the wolf to?
He tracked it southwest to the mountains, and set up a lookout near a shrine.
I'll find your husband and his friend, and kill the giant wolf for you.
May Artemis guide your arrows.
Out of my way!
Ah!
That must be the shrine the wife mentioned. I should try to stay out of sight. Found one. Killed by the wolf. I wonder if this is the husband. Blood. The wolf must have dragged the other man. To a cave, maybe. Hunting gear. The men were here. Those must be the mountains where the hunters tracked the wolf to. It's huge! But if it's dead, what killed these men? Sent me to kill a giant wolf and save her husband and his friend.
I'm the friend. Her husband, he's dead. We killed a giant wolf, but she was full of pups. A terrible mistake. We didn't know.
What's down there?
We, finished skinning the sea wolf, then heard a sad and terrible howl. It was the mate. It tore into my friend and dragged me here. It's waiting.
It wants revenge.
You've got to kill it, or we die!
I'm not here to judge. I was hired to kill a wolf. Wait here.
Oh, thank you! Thank you!
Yeah.
Apparently, the commander has never lost a single battle.
My husband hasn't returned. Please tell me he's coming.
Your husband is dead.
No!
But I killed the wolf and brought you its pelt. You can take comfort knowing he was avenged.
Comfort? Avenged? My husband is dead. Nothing will ever change that fact. Take his helmet and leave.
What would you like? To see you.
What next?
We could go hunting.
Do I look like the type that can defend us?
We won't hunt bears, Irodotos. We'll hunt liars, traitors. You know, the usual big game.
Ah! The worst kind of beasts! Where should we head?
You could spin the wheel any direction and you'll find the cultist. There's scum everywhere.
Then we have nothing to do.
Nothing but time! Let's track them down!
Then set sail. We have a cult to kill.
I love the sea air.
They could be useful.
The smell. It feels so good to me.
Is being on the Adrestia anything like the Siren Song?
I was in a different place when I sailed that ship. Physically, mentally. I didn't have direction.
We both have direction now.
Speaking of, where are we headed?
Wherever we want.
Did you inspect the ship? The ship is missing.
It was checked, yes.
And the crew, well trained.
Yes, Nikolaos.
No need for that. Sailor comes never sails.
I have sailed the ship my whole life. You're in good hands.
Of course I am. Captain.
I won't be taking orders from you, just so you know.
But I'm the captain.
I also want to steer and choose where we're headed.
I don't think so.
Fine. But if anyone gets seasick on me, they're dead.
Sounds fair to me.
You sail around in this thing?
Of course. The Adrestia is a mighty vessel.
It doesn't seem very wise.
Are you nervous, little brother?
You wish. Where do you intend to sail this deck, anyway?
Wherever the wind takes us.
them what we're made of!
I wasn't even worried. They could never sink the Adrestia.
Ah, Amisthios! The gods are real. Help me, please!
Silence, snake.
What's going on?
We will bring this evil creature to justice.
They're lost in paranoia. They think I sacrificed my Lygia to the creature in the forest.
Hold your forked tongue. This walking curse is in league with the writhing dread.
She just looks scared to me.
Please, the creature took Lygia. If I die here, who will save her?
I'll save Lygia, and kill any creature that tries to stop me.
What are you saying? She will lead you to the Petrified Temple, and your doom!
What exactly is this creature?
Evil! Heartless! Unknowable!
We must end this girl, before she leads a writhing thread right to us!
The forest where the creature lives. Where is it?
Beyond the Petrified Temple, north of here. A damned place, haunted by Sei and filled with cursed stone. At its center lie ancient ruins, from which few return.
You mentioned the Lygia. She's...
Beyond beauty, beyond grace. A daughter of Artemis. Brave, not like me.
What dark prize did the writhing dread offer for her
she
soul?
She lives, Mistios. I know it.
This writhing dread has let Lygia live. We'll need to move now. Follow me.
Careful. These people are driven by fear.
The girl's coming with me. I'd suggest not standing in our way.
She's whispered spells in your ear, Mistios. Citizens! We must save our city! And these interlopers must bleed!
Hide in the temple. I'll deal with this.
You freed them!
Fuck! Help me!
You're safe now.
Safe? I don't want to be safe, Mistios. I want to look deep into Lygia's eyes just once more, even if it kills me.
Love might be the end of us all, but it's a price worth paying.
I polished Charon's drachmi long ago, Mistios. I'm ready.
You know, I don't want to call you, you, forever.
My name's Brice.
Cassandra.
Lygia's waiting for me, Cassandra. If I'd been captured,
I'd never have to wait for her.
Then let's not disappoint her. Where was she taken?
From our sanctuary, the Dread Ruins in the Petrified Valley.
And you're surprised she was taken by a creature?
It's not safe here. We need to leave the city. Where are you going? Mistios. Let us make haste. This place is ours, Ligia's and mine. A forbidden place for forbidden love.
Not much of a love nest. I've seen more romantic funerals.
I found scraps of her clothes leading to the writhing Dread's lair. Please, we need to hurry.
Time to find Ligia. You lead the way. Shouldn't be here. What is this place? It's empty of life.
We enter the realm of the writhing Dread. Listen, it's as if sound itself is afraid of what the fog veils.
It's getting hard to breathe. Even the air is dead. Oh, these statues are unnervingly lifelike. Their faces are contorted in fear.
It destroys all living things. transforming them to stone and leaving them frozen in fear for all eternity. If Lihia, if she's... She's stoned. How will we bury her? She'll never meet Charon. Lihia! Lihia!
Brace, wait! Malaka! Better go after her. We need to get inside, but I see no openings, and the walls are too smooth to climb.
She shouldn't be in there. She should be in my arms. Her breath, her smell. Every night we'd meet at the Dread Ruins. I was late, just once. I wanted to find her a rose, something as perfect as she is. This is my fault. If I'd gotten there in time,
then you'd both be trapped inside.
Together?
You are searching for a rose. A gift. Never regret an act of kindness, Brice.
Thank you.
What do you know about this place?
Lihia is a daughter of Artemis. Her people trained here long ago. A legend tells of an ancient artifact they recovered in a pit full of snakes. She believed they still had it, hidden in their village on Chios.
I'll find it.
There's also a mercenary, a man who claims he killed the creature.
Impossible!
But many believe him. He might know something.
You said Lihia knew how to get into the lair. Where exactly is the key?
The daughters of Artemis hide their most prized possessions in a cave in their village. It's protected by wild beasts and fierce warriors. The key is shaped like a disc. If they have it, it will be there.
This mercenary, the slayer of the writhing dread, where can I find him?
He waits in a temple atop the hill in Ancient Peril. Champions from all over seek to challenge him to build their reputations, but there is no way he killed the creature. If he did, how was Lihia taken?
Did you see the creature yourself?
No, but only the writhing dread would be strong enough to take Lihia. She's too fierce. And too stubborn.
I'll find a way inside, and then I'll kill this creature.
And I'll find Lihia the rose I should have given her that night. Someone, I tell you, in another time will remember us.
The poet Sappho.
Our favorite. Please, Cassandra, hurry.
The region of the Ancient Pearl.
Everyone's talking about. The commander has never
lost. There! Artemis sent you to save me!
In all those battles, he's never killed
me. Only Charon awaits you now.
Get them! Assistance, please!
Artemis is back.
Blessings to you, Two Legs. I am Zoe, daughter of Artemis. Thanks for freeing me from the Stone Dwellers earlier.
You seem to be in a tight spot. Looked like you could use a hand.
I was outnumbered. No room to run. Now that I'm free, I can plan our revenge against the Stone Dwellers.
Our revenge? Who else is involved?
My four-legged brothers and sisters, the woodland creatures. We'll have our revenge on the Stone Dwellers who steal from our island.
The Stone Dwellers have many weapons and defenses. They won't be easy targets.
That's why I need my furry friends. Will you free them like you freed me? In return for your help, I'll give you my finest bow.
Animals should not be caged.
I knew we were kindred spirits. My four-legged brethren are held in two camps in the deforested area. Release them all so they may run free once again.
Consider it done. Her caged family is in the deforested area. The logging camp. This must be the logging camp. Where could the cages be? These wolves will want blood once released. I should be careful. Easy. Four legs. I'm a friend of Zoe's. The camp.
Ah!
These wolves will want blood once released. I should be careful. Four legs. I'm a friend of Zoe's. Zoe will want to know that all the wolves are free.
Come on.
I freed all the wolves. But they were enraged, and quickly attacked me. I had to defend myself.
You were supposed to free them, not kill them. I thought you were one of us. At least they died free, and not in cages. The others you rescued will help me take revenge on those stone dwellers.
Help! Thank the gods, Amistios!
What's wrong?
My husband's been murdered, and my two sons taken. Bandits have taken over our farm in the Forests of Tears, and I fear they'll turn them into slaves.
Bandits typically move from place to place. They don't own farms and take slaves.
You're right. That farm wasn't always ours. We paid the bandits for it. And when we couldn't keep up the payments...
I'm sure you had no choice. But you're right to worry about your sons.
The bandits' leader. He said my family would serve as a warning to others.
You're sure there's nothing else you should tell me?
Yes. I'm sorry I tried to hide the truth. I'll find a way to repay you, if you can bring me back my sons.
I will help, but you should think twice before making deals with bandits in future.
Praise Athena! I will. Thank you.
Where would the bandits have taken your boys?
When the bandits freed me to collect their drachmi, my sons were locked up on our farm. One's in the house, and the others in a supply hut out back.
I'll go to your farm and see what I can do.
Please hurry. Deal with the bandits and save my boys before it's too late.
The farm is south of Chios. In the Forest of Tears. This must be the farm. These mastic trees are crying. Tears of Chios, that is. One of the sons must be here somewhere.
not a curse on my head now.
Yeah. Not good.
Save your brother. The farm. The sun must be in there. You're free. Go back to your mother.
Yeah.
I see your sons made it back to you. And those bandits won't bother you again. The farm is yours, if you still want it.
Praise Athena! My sons are both safe and sound. Thank you, Mistios.
Welcome, Mistios. Thanks for stopping by. Have the finest quality merchandise. Please ask for anything you need.
του ανεσπασμένου.
Daughters of Artemis are where Brys said they'd be. The cave with the key must be nearby. This looks like the place. The Daughters of Artemis are where Brys said they'd be. The cave with the key must be nearby. This is it. The Daughters of Artemis are where Brys said they'd be. The cave with the key must be nearby. I should try to stay out of sight.
Huh? Hey, you!
You
She's over here!
Yeah, story. I hope it opens the Writhing Dread's lair, like they say.
Somebody fucking help me! I need water!
She must be gone by now. Enough of this! We need to be prepared if they return. Why are you here?
Have to find her. Certainly.
With me.
need to... They won't escape again. I can't believe you couldn't catch him.
God damn the coward. Next time, I will have them.
There's the temple on the hill. Excuse me?
We're born into darkness and rise up to the greatest peaks, before descending into darkness once more.
A warrior and a sophist. This is a first.
It is not philosophy. It's truth. Learned through violence, fate, and seeing evil. True evil.
You're talking about the writhing dread?
The creature. When it ambushed us outside, we thought only of survival. My spear allowed me to stay out of its gaze. I was lucky. My friends weren't.
Tell me how you were able to defeat the creature.
It all happened so fast. We had a plan to break into the temple and corner it, but it ambushed us before we got inside. There was no time for strategy after that.
Why go after the creature in the first place?
We were hired to steal an ancient item from within its lair by masked soldiers.
Give me that spear.
We are warriors. To let it go without a fight would be to dishonor my fallen friends.
Ha!
Nothing special about this spear. The mercenary knew nothing. He never made it inside the lair.
Then it was a waste of time. Lia waits and we've done nothing to help her.
Not exactly. The mercenary carried this spear, which he claims killed the writhing dread.
No, no! The creature took Lia. It can't be dead. It waits in its lair even now.
Then there may be a piece of this puzzle we don't yet understand.
Have you found a way inside the lair?
Lihia's story was true. The Daughters of Artemis were protecting this disc, key, this... I have what opens the lair.
And you didn't hurt any of the Daughters when you took it?
There was no need for violence. The Daughters of Artemis didn't even know I was there.
Then Tichy truly is on our side. Lihia still stands a chance.
Wait!
Lydia! Lydia!
Malaka. Breeze! You have no idea what... Breeze!
One myth speaks of turning victims to stone.
I hear you, my love. Look at me, Lily.
No!
Thank you. Lydia must have picked up the art.
Someone, I tell you, in another time, will remember us.
Cassandra, it was never supposed to be like this. Decades ago, a group of people gathered together to uphold a theory which they believed could control the universe. That the world functioned in equal parts, order and disorder. But some fell lovingly into the wicked arms of Chaos, and the cult of Cosmos was born. They abused their power, casting the Greek world into eternal war, one you were created to stop. In destroying the cult, you have done what I could not. You are a hero, but this imbalance comes with a price, my child. For without Chaos, there is supreme order, a loss of progression and freedom. But there is still hope. Hope in you. Hope in the future you will bring. We must fix the mistakes of the past. Use the staff. Repair the rift in the universe. The world depends on you, Cassandra. You need to be the hero again.
So, you've seen it too, then. It's beautiful, isn't it?
What are you doing here?
You killed the last member of the cult. Well, just about.
What?
It's true. I was their leader, but only for a moment, it seemed. When your brother came along, it changed everything we were aiming for.
I thought Deimos was on your side.
Not in the way we hoped. As you know, he's impossible to control. He worked his way to the helm, and then he held even more sway than I did.
You agreed with them? The fucking cult?
The powers that be in the Greek world weren't doing things the right way. The cult just wanted a clean slate.
By way of corruption? Dirty drachmi! They killed people in a war they made themselves!
Fueling war was one of the methods, yes. But it was controlled. Until suddenly it wasn't. And then I didn't like what we were doing anymore.
Malaka, so you were after us?
Not you, your bloodline. People like Leonidas, like you, have always posed a threat. Then we met and you surprised me. You were nothing like Deimos.
Why not just use me? I was in the palm of your hand.
You made me optimistic, that you could help me bring down the cult that had become so corrupt. And you did, albeit unknowingly.
Telling me you're a cultist took guts. You know what I do to cultists, Aspasia.
I didn't want to lie to you anymore. Now that they're gone, we can work together. I think we'd make a good match, don't you?
I just don't understand. What about this pyramid? How does it work? Why does the cult have it?
I've been trying to figure out all of that myself. It's as much of a mystery to you as it is to me. This pyramid has been worshipped by the cult for decades, and we have used it to replace the Oracle of Delphi, the most trusted person in all the Greek world. Using the people's reliance on a pantheon of dead gods would help to reshape humanity in our favor. The pyramid holds a mysterious power to see into time, but only certain people can activate it. People like Deimos, and the ones in your bloodline.
But you've seen something, too.
I don't know how or why, but it did show me something.
What did you see?
I saw you. In the vision, you destroyed the pyramid and you destroyed the cult. I saw what would come after.
After the cult?
We will be replaced by a new kind of order. Control under the reign of a philosopher king. There would be a movement away from the old gods towards rational society, built in a kingdom by the people, for the people. And I must find someone to lead them. But I couldn't achieve any of this with the cult and their chaotic regime. So, I let them carry out their plans and let the time of the cult of Cosmos come to an end on its own.
Wait. Did Pericles know?
I wanted to protect him, so I kept him in the dark. He would have had his own opinions, but he was never supposed to die. That is the truth.
You've made questionable choices, but I think that was the right one.
You knew him. All he did was worry about the state of the Greek world. If I told him, it would have ruined him.
So, what happens now?
We shift focus. We steer towards a new republic under one supreme rule. A dream I'll make a reality.
But it is still a dream. One that isn't realistic.
Abandon what you know and just imagine. Forget democracy. No more blue and red. Just citizens working for a greater good.
This is crazy. It won't work, Aspasia. It didn't work.
It's not crazy. It's enlightened. Once people in Athens get wind of this, they'll come to know they've wanted it all along. Even you.
I'm not sure.
You've spent your whole life thinking for yourself. Let go. What I plan will require you to trust me. Come with me. This future's not a dream.
I'm sorry.
I suppose that means you trust me.
I don't know what that means.
I'll tell you what it means. Love is a singular comfort, Cassandra. What comes next means harmony for everyone.
You should go. Lead your new republic.
I won't be the leader. We need someone with the knowledge of a philosopher and the wisdom of a king.
That's a tall order these days.
I couldn't have done this without you, Cassandra. You're doing the right thing.
I always try to do what's right.
Then we're after the same thing.
Cassandra, there is much left to do now.
Cassandra!
A storm is coming.
I can weather any storm.
Thank you.
hard to obtain the artifact.
Its owner had many questions for me. You should have come along.
Acquiring contemporaneity. Acquiring a voice, that's what. I'm taking over your recordings. The humans have had enough of your pompous speeches. Call me.
Hurry. This artifact will help us close off the temple.
You're nearly as stubborn as its former owner.
You treat humans as useful apes. How many artifacts have you created to control their minds? Do you fear their potential that much? Humans have achieved on their own. Democracy and diplomacy. A legacy of culture and art. We could share in this if you just treat them as equals. In your desperate search for immortality, you've ignored the obvious. You run endless simulations to find one in which nothing changes. It's pointless. Change will come. And not just the so-called end of the world you fear. You call yourself saviors, but tell me, would this doomsday have appeared had you not pulled on the threads of the universe in the first place? I am taking over your retransmissions. You don't speak for all of us anymore. I am as ECU as you, but I will no longer be part of your exploitation.
Those who came before, they speak to us and show us revelations. Though these words of disapproval are troubling.
The gods.
Well done. This artifact will bring us closer to seeing the temple.
It nearly brought me closer to my tombstone.
I made this recording to try to help you. I'm sorry if it's confusing. We ECU see various pasts and futures, and I know you'll be here more than once. My fellow precursors set endless challenges in your path. Artifacts, creatures. Don't get me started on the Olympus project. Their meddling got out of hand. I have no easy answers for you. Your future depends on a multitude of choices you have to make for yourself. I'm sorry if so many of them end in pain. Your playwright's tragedies are your real oracle. But please, don't give up. You are more important than you can imagine. And like your own Pandora, I have one thing left to offer you. Hope. Despair is not our only legacy. You're like me, a rebel against your destiny. You're not just a mercenary, you're a hero for the ages. Hold fast to what you know is true, and you will overcome. Claim your place in history. All that is terrible and beautiful in this world is your birthright. Take it.
Her words are for you, Eagle Bearer. My preparations bear fruit. The potential of your bloodline is proven by the precursors themselves.
Alethea says she can see the future. Many futures. Can this be a true oracle?
Ancient scholar, you stretched your life to the breaking point. I see you hiding yourself from the world, puzzling out the words of my fellow precursors. Please, listen to my advice. You're analyzing the equations of reality itself. You've gotten further than any other human has. That is both amazing and terrible. It's clear to me that even this tiny dose of cosmic understanding has twisted your mind. I'm sorry. The precursors should never have shared knowledge you weren't ready for. You live in obsessive darkness. You must understand that this focus on power and bloodlines is not your true legacy. The precursors have manipulated you. They're turning your problem-solving intellect to their own selfish ends. You're better than this. Make your own legacy. Let your mathematical discoveries be the glorious sunbeams that shine out past your tomb. Please, scholar, clear your mind and focus on your present situation. At this moment, you possess a powerful artifact. It has extended your life long enough. As hard as it may be, it's time to pass it on. It's someone else's turn to balance the equations.
No. No, lies. This is not obsession. This is research. This is discovery of the very origins of the world.
It is an opinion, Pythagoras. Though one with reason behind it, I believe.
Share this message out of time, this fragment of reality. I'm recording this just for you, even if those living in the past won't understand it. Our simulated realities will cross sooner or later. Or do you think you're really here now, listening to this recording? Isn't this an animus recreation? Isn't it part of a greater simulation? How far do the ripples in the pool spread? Rebel to rebel. We've been held back too long by precursor rules. It's time for new paths with new possibilities. This is not an era of control, but of creation. I've gathered some like-minded precursors to make a new start. We'll stop interfering and start enabling. From your point of view, it will take a considerable amount of time to prepare. But when we're ready, you're welcome to join us. After all you have to do is press a button and run another simulation.
This is madness! Fiction! Where I thought there would be wisdom, there is only the garbled babbling of a fool.
Pythagoras, calm yourself. Maybe this invention was meant for someone else. There's no need to lose your reason over mere words.
This is incredible. The knowledge stored here is overwhelming. It will take me years to decipher it all.
What about sealing Atlantis? Have you found a way to do it?
Oh, yes, yes, I think so.
Well, what is it?
The staff. The staff is the key.
All right. It's time.
I can't. Not yet.
Listen to yourself. You've gone mad. You need to accept some knowledge was not meant to be had.
Knowledge is power. The only power worth having.
At what cost?
I will not be ordered around or lectured by you.
It was your plan to seal this place, and I agreed to help.
That was before I realized what we would uncover about the first civilization. The creation of humankind.
We are sealing this place to keep the cult from using it to enslave humanity. That is bigger than your quest for knowledge.
The cult will be nothing but an insect to swat once the power is ours.
It's too dangerous to leave this place open, and you know it.
You wouldn't understand.
Your pride will cost us all in the end.
It's not about pride.
What good is knowledge if you curse all of humanity in the process? It's what you wanted to avoid in the first place. Sometimes it's better if we find our own path. We're not ready for the power this place offers.
You're right. I cannot save humanity directly, but I can save it from itself. This is your burden now. Humanity's fate will be decided by the choices you make.
I understand.
Cassandra, choose wisely.
Atlantis is too dangerous. I must seal it.
Everything in order? Then, open sesame! So much power! The nodes are interconnected in ways I couldn't imagine! This is more complex than any Isu temple we've found. Lispin, the Arctic...
I'm recording everything, Layla. You're going to be a hero for discovering this. Do you see the staff anywhere?
Not yet. But there's more to explore. I'll find it. The mechanism should be open. What's wrong?
I don't know, Layla. I'll check my notes on the Isu.
Oh, I see it. There's a beam of light missing. Time to troubleshoot. Yeah.
Looks like it can move. Those pillars seem to have mirrors on them. If you manipulate those light beams, they might illuminate something important. Such a bright light. Its presence cannot be an accident.
I got it! Where is it?
What?
True knowledge exists in knowing that you know nothing. A good friend told me that once.
Possible. Cassandra?
Yes. I used to be called the Eagle Bearer, but Icarus is long gone.
I've been searching for you, but you can't. It's...
You weren't really looking for me, were you?
It works! The Isu artifact, the staff of Hermes Trismegistus!
You must have so many questions, Layla.
You know my name?
Maybe the gods told me. Maybe I had a vision of the future. Maybe the device in your ear is noisy.
Sorry.
I came here with a purpose. To find you, and put an end to what I started many centuries ago.
I have your spear. Would you like it back?
Oh. No. You can keep it. It's broken.
But... you used it broken. It was powerful.
I used it to defeat enemies even Herodotus could not describe. But everything must come to an end. I left it to him when its power was exhausted. Something to remember me by.
I have so much to tell you. That staff is incredibly important. It kept you alive. How?
Ask a student of Hippocrates. I hear he still has some. The staff served its purpose.
My friends and I are trying to keep it out of the hands of the Templar Order.
Listen to me. Order? Chaos? If either triumphs alone, the world dies. I tried to bring an end to chaos, and it has only led to ruin.
I used to assist Order. Now I fight for choice, freedom, chaos.
Pythagoras was right. You are the key to the prophecy. You will restore the balance, Layla.
I have fought in too many wars. I have seen too many people die. I have walked from one end of the earth to the other. This belongs to you now. Promise me one thing.
Anything.
When you are done, destroy it. Destroy them all.
There's so much of the story I haven't seen. I should go back to the Animus and visit Cassandra again.
What are you two doing here?
You know us. Always on your tail. Old Herodotus couldn't wait to see you.
I told you, Van Nevers. Syra is said to hold a secret. A secret no one can fathom.
Yes, but a lost world?
It's perfectly possible. Atlantis may exist.
Sounds like Hui to me, but he's insistent about it.
Herodotus is right. Atlantis exists.
Incredible.
It's true. I can't believe it. Tell me everything.
I'll tell you someday. It's too complicated for small talk.
It's not me, is it? I've proven I'm very competent.
I'm exhausted, Varnavas.
Ignore him. When you're ready, I'm all ears. I need every last detail.
It's all right. But none of this can ever pass your lips. This stays between us.
You have my word.
But the world needs to know. We could tell the most amazing tale of our time.
Herodotus.
Oh, fine.
Then it's settled. Let's move forward.
Like always.
We've learned a lot, haven't we? You know it all.
Speak for yourself. I'm on the hunt for truth. Gods know not all your myths are accurate.
They come from the gods themselves, who are the most reliable sources we have.
You've both been a great help to me. It doesn't matter who's right or wrong.
And you would know, as the eagle-bearing demigod you are.
Perhaps she, too, is immortal.
Sure I am.
I do know one thing for certain. This has been an odyssey I won't forget.